الدكتور محمد حسني خلاص الواجب بتاعك النهارده خلاص.
ممكن
هو
الموضوع ايه بالظبط؟
لا موضوع ايه، ما فيش حد ابنائي هو ده قال دلوقتي اللي قال الدكتور محمد عبد المجيد. ماشي
تمام رحنا
نعم يا فندم.
تمام.
لا 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 مش سامع حضرتك.
محمد عبد المجيد
الو
تمام. ايوه
ايه يا دكتور محمد، سامعك كده يا فندم.
ماشي تمام.
انت حالتك النهارده حاله صعبه شويه، ربنا يسهل. الاول انت عملت كوميونيكيشن قبل كده ولا لا؟
كنت دخلت الاجزام كده مرة،
نعم.
دخلت الاجزام مرة قبل كده.
لا طبعا خالص. ماشي. You are senior house officer in the medical board. Mr. Ibrahim admitted 3 weeks back with right side weakness and aphasia.
رايت سايد ويكنس
And aphasia, yes. He received medication. Unfortunately, his condition doesn't improve. Your consultant assists the patient and asked you to speak with his son, Mr. Ali, as he needs for his father big tube insertion. يعني the consultant asked for big tube insertion because the patient cannot swallow and cannot feed himself. Your task to explain to him, to the son, يعني patient, the medical condition of the patient and the procedure.
ركب له رايد ولا اللي هي البيج تيوب؟
بيك تيو.
يمين انجل في رحلة مش كده؟
لا هنحط بيك تيوب انسيرشن.
جاستريستوم تيوب يعني جاستريستوم تيوب.
في الحالة اللي فاتت يا دكتورة رشا، البيشنت عندي بيشتكي من الكرنت اتاك اوف سينكو، وان عشان اعمل البيشنت 24 اور اي سي جي اند امبولاتري انا و24 اور بلاد بريشر، وي شود كيب ميت تو ذا هوسبيتال اند هي تيلتنج تيست، وي شود كيب ذا بيشنت تو ذا هوسبيتال ات ليست فور 24 اور كوز البيشنت هاز مين ريسك فاكتور. اف يو سسبكت ذا بيشنت تي اي اي ذير از اي بي سي دي سكور. اي بي سي دي سكور مينز اف ذا بيشنت هاز دايابيتس هي ويل تيك 2، اف ذا بيشنت سوري 1، If the patient has hypertension more than 140 over 90, he will take another one. If there is any deficit, he will take another one. This is 3. 3 from 7 or 4 from 7, patient, you should keep the patient for the hospital for 24 hours. Hello? احنا يا فندم عندنا حاجة اسمها الـ ABCD score. الـ ABCD score اللي هو الـ age بتاع الـ patient لو أكتر من 65، الـ B اللي هي الـ blood pressure more than 140 over 90، الـ C اللي هي الـ clinical لو في weakness أو في aphasia، لو في aphasia weakness لو في weakness أو في aphasia واحدة فيهم بتاخد واحد والتانية بتاخد اتنين، أعتقد الـ weakness بياخد اتنين. يعني دي الديابيتس، اوكي، و عفوا دي اللي هي الديابيتس، سوري دي اللي هي الديابيتس والديس ارسي، السي اللي هي الكلينيكال، لو في ويكنس اقل من ساعة او اكتر من ساعة، اقل من ساعة ياخد واحد واكتر من ساعة ياخد اتنين، اقل من 10 دقايق ما بياخدش حاجة.
أنا جاهز يا دكتور.
ماشي يا فندم.
أبتدي؟
اتفضل يا حسن حبيبي.
جود أفترنون.
جود أفترنون.
أنا دكتور محمد عبد المجيد من هاوس أوف فرنز كلينيك. أم أي توكينج تو مستر علي؟
يس.
أنت مستر علي أر يو ذا نكست أوف كين أوف مستر إبراهيم؟
يس.
I'm here today to discuss some issue as the health status of your father. Is it okay?
Yes, doctor, that's okay.
Do you want any other member to attend the meeting with you?
No.
Okay, Mr. Ali. First, I want to ask you what's your information about your father's health?
Yes, doctor. My father, 3 weeks ago, he developed a weakness on the right side and he can't speak. I seek the medical advice, and the physician informed me in the emergency. My father had a heart brain attack, and there's a huge infarction in the brain. After that, he was admitted to the stroke unit, and he has been receiving medication, but it doesn't help him. He also receiving that through a tube through his nose, and the consultant told me that there is a daily assessment of the father, and according to the response of the father, the management plan will be changed.
Yes, I'm sorry for your father's health, Mr. Ali, but I'm here today to explain more what we need to do. First, you know that we have this tube in the father for a few, but unfortunately, it's a problem that he cannot swallow or consume food more. And this tube is causing him to have some food to pass the air pipes. So we need to change this tube to another form of tube. Are you following me?
Yes, doctor, I'm with you. Why, doctor, do you want to change this tube?
So, as I told you, it's not expected for your father to regain his swallowing ability early. It's because of the effect of this large brain attack. It had affected his swallowing. So we will need to do him another type of feeding pathway because this tube in his nose is not appropriate for a long time. It has many complications, like as I told you, it may be dislodged or may have aspiration. Aspiration, I mean that food particles may pass through his air pipes, causing his chest to have some problems.
Yes.
So we will need to do another tube for him. This called the big tube, or a tube that passes directly to his stomach.
It is a serious procedure, doctor?
It's not a serious procedure. Of course, any procedure will have some, may have some complications, but it's rare in this procedure, and it's not very serious. First, I would like to draw a diagram for you describing what exactly I mean. This diagram will show that we will pass away the food pipe in the chest and insert this tube directly to the stomach. this will be done under super or under vision by rays or by imaging. That's called ultrasound. Are you following me, Mr. Ali?
Yes, doctor. I am with you.
Yes. As I told you, this tube will be inserted under the imaging, passed directly to the stomach, and after then the food that is considered digested or that easily digested or suitable food will be inserted through this tube. This tube will decrease the risk of aspiration. I mean the food particles that will pass to the air pipes by accident. So you get this word, aspiration.
Yes,
you understand this word?
Yes, doctor. I understood it.
Yes. So this this tube will decrease markedly the risk of this aspiration and will protect the chest of your father from this aspiration, which is, if it cared, it markedly deteriorates the condition. See?
Okay.
Okay. So, what you feel about this, Mr.
For how long you will keep this tube for to feed my father?
It's really, I couldn't give you an exact time for this period of this tube, but as I told you, it will need it will be not less than months. So we need to do this tube, and after that we can retest the swallowing ability of your father. If he can regain this swallowing ability, we may remove it. But if it he cannot regain his swallowing ability, it will continue with him for a long time.
Yes, doctor. Will you discharge him from the hospital with this tube?
If his condition is stable, yes, he will be educated, or he will, or the caregiver of him will be educated how to deal with tube, and the food also that can be given through this tube, you will educated about this, and you can be able to deal with this tube, and there will be a regular up with our team.
Yes, doctor.
Yes. So I want to ask you about your concerns, Ali.
I'm concerned about this change of feeding type. Also, I want to ask about the prognosis and outlook of my father's condition. When he will start to feed himself again, when will he start to move his hands?
Okay, sir. I appreciate your concern, Mr. Ali. As regards the big tube, I hope that I have explained to you that we need this big tube to protect his chest from aspiration. Is not effective. We need to do it. Also, as regards the prognosis of your father, it is not clearly now about his prognosis, but we hope that we'll follow up with his multidisciplinary which will do the physician and the speech therapist and the physical therapist and the occupational therapist. He may regain some of his condition, may regain some of his condition back, or his can do some activities again.
Okay.
Okay. I would like also to explain to Mr. Ali that this tube, as you asked it, it may have some risks, but it is no risk. May have some risk of infection, maybe slow jet or away from its place. So it has some complications, but it's very from operation that I have explained.
Okay.
Also, as we are in UK, it is not your own responsibility to decide for this big tube. It's also the decision of his medical team that will do in his best interests. But it's good practice to be one team and to share every in the plan of management of your father. So what do you feel about this?
Okay, doctor, I agree for that.
Okay, that's good, Mr. Ali. Do you want any other concerns or anything that is not clear?
No, thanks, doctor.
Okay, so thank you, Mr. Ali.
Thank you. Quite, Dr. Mohammed. You did well, but what do you think? What is the ethical issue in this scenario and the law issue in this scenario?
I think the ethical issue is autonomy of the patient and beneficence also. And regard the ethical legal issue, it's acting in the best interest of the patient.
What is the autonomy of the patient in this case? What is the autonomy of the patient?
Autonomy, it cannot decide for himself. So it's the responsibility of his team to act in his best interest.
What do you think? If the patient cannot take decision, who will take decision?
I think it's his medical team.
Medical team.
Yes.
Do you think you should inform his son about the consent or no?
Legally, legally I shouldn't ask the son for consent, but ethically it's a good practice for me to share his next in the plan of management of his path.
Yes, it's very important. You should tell the son about that.
Yes.
After you asked him, how do you feel about, how do you think about the big tube insertion? Tell him like that. It is the consultant, he will sign the consent instead of your father. But we will be happy if you sign this consent. And if there is any complication happened to your father, it is you are not responsible about that, because legally the consultant he should sign about the consent. Yeah, he should mention
yes.
it to him. Yeah, he should mention it. I know. I am with you. I am
yes,
with you.
هو ممكن هو عند
Oh yes, he can. But is if he can, if he refused, خلاص, no problem. يعني. It is
yes.
because ethically you should inform him about the consent, but legal
yes.
he hadn't right to refuse the procedure for his father.
Yes.
Okay. So that what about any instruction giving to the son about the big tube? You should inform the son that you will submit a paper for him. This paper contains big tube about the big procedure and about the risk of this procedure and the advantage of this procedure.
Yes.
You should, يعني, to should give the patient, give the family help.
Yes, yes.
يعني, to tell him to read that, to see that, to like this, يعني, it's very, very important.
Okay.
Also, you should summarize the important point in this scenario. يعني, you should inform him, your father developed brain attack. And this attack causes huge defect in the brain that affecting your father movement and affecting the swallowing of the food. And it is not wise to keep this to keep feeding from the nose for more than 3 weeks. So that we want to do a procedure. It is called big tube insertion, and I will refer you to the physician. It's called gastroenterology physician. He's expert and he will give you more instruction and he will insert this to you for him. This in summary, يعني. You should ask him also how he got from this discussion to confirm he understood your explanation. يعني you did well during all during a scenario, you did well, but finishing of the scenario you should summarize, you should check understanding, you should give to the patient paper about family of the patient, family's patient paper about the big tube and about the risk of the procedure and about the complication could be having during procedure. It's very very important, this issue. I will, during the start of the scenario, I want from you to explain a little bit about stroke. You started directly to big tube. Okay, you should, يعني you should inform him at the start what is meaning by stroke and how this stroke affected his father's condition. Okay.
هو كان على أساس إن هو فاهم يعني هو was understanding from his GP.
Yes, yes, I am with you. يعني he understood already, but you should give him more. This is affecting many center of the brain and one of center responsible about the movement and other center responsible about the swelling, and this center affecting your father's condition. We started for him medication and we started to feed him through a nose, through the nose by tube. But it's not wise. After that, to start to complete to explain the big tube procedure.
Okay.
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 This one during the start and the ending of the discussion. When he asked you about his father's condition, for how long you will keep him to the hospital? You answered these questions well. You told him about the we can send it to whom and giving an instruction to him. But I want for you to ask who will give care of this patient in the home. Okay, is there anyone will keep contact with his father in the home because his father will be ridden. He won't nurse with him in the home. You should raise this issue with the family. Why? If there's no family member available at the home, what is your responsibility of physician to help this this family?
He'll be admitted.
You will keep him for how long to the hospital? The hospital is only for acute cases.
Now, care,
yes, it is very very important. You will tell him if you raise this issue and he told you he can't take care of his father in the house because he's working. And his wife working and no one available to be in contact with his father. Tell him we can arrange this issue with social worker. We can transfer your father to other hospital. It is called long-term care. They will take care of your father and you can see him at any time or visit him at any time. This is very, very important. Long-term care for bedridden patient or chronic cases. In summary, this scenario, we should know about consent, very, very important. We should know what is the responsibility of the next of kin. He should sign the consent or no, or he can refuse the procedure or no. Third issue in this one, to treatment of chronic cases. Very important to speak about multidisciplinary team. Here in this patient, we should speak about neurologist. And the dietitian and the speech therapy and the physiotherapy. also summary, we should not forget summary, or we shouldn't also forget to how much he got from this discussion. And lastly we want to give the patient some pamphlet and leaflet about the condition. Any questions on this issue؟
دكتور احمد
اتفضل يا فندم.
هو بس regarding the procedure، يعني هو دكتور محمد هو منشن بس اللي هي الترا ساوند it is
انا كتبتها
كاميرا تيست مش الترا ساوند.
ايوه انا كتبتها جنبي فعلا، انا كنت فعلا صح. انا مش هو ممكن في بعض الناس في بعض السنترز بيعملوها الترا ساوند بس ما تسمعش بيك تيوب، اسمها جاستروستومي جاستروستوم ستوب. ماشي، يعني هو بيحط فيدنج تيوب، بيفتح انسجن ويحط تيوب زي زي الكاستر بيحطها، لكن ويخيط بعد كده اندر سونار جايدد. ماشي، لكن البيج انسيرشن اسمها بيركوتينيوس جاستروسمو تيوب عن طريق الاندوسكوبي، ماشي، مش عن طريق التانية اسمها جاستروستومي تيوب.
وكمان احمد دكتور احمد، احنا لازم طبعا اكسبلين ذا بيشن ويل تيك انستيزيا اند سيديشن دورينج ذا بروسيدجر، دي از امبورتنت اولسو. يعني
شور هو البيشنت لو كونشس، طبعا احنا عندنا زي ما الدكتور محمد عارف عندنا باس واي معين للبيشنت اللي بيعمل اي بروسيدور. يعني عشان اعمل اكسبلين للبروسيدور لازم نتكلم الاول عن what you will do, what will you do for the patient before procedure, and what will you do during the procedure, and what will you do after procedure. يعني should divide that before procedure you will tell the patient instructions during the procedure what will you do and after procedure. إن شاء الله we'll speak about in other cases.
دكتور احمد، اخر حاجه بس، هو المفروض طبعا في الاول مهم جدا ان انا اقول له does your father explain any pain and the assure the relative or the son that you will give him pain killer and the patient will be comfortable will not feel any pain. دي برضو مهمه في الاول يعني.
طبعا بس هو الكلام في الحاله دي كتير جدا على فكره، يعني الحاله دي عشان تعملها في 14 minutes
محتاجه وقت،
محتاجه وقت كتير. فهي يعني عشان تلم كل حاجة هتتكلم شوية على ال 1 to 2 minutes بس على الهارت، على الستروك، بعد كده هتتكلم على البيك تيوب، لأن البيك تيوب انسيرشن لوحدها محتاجة كلام كتير جدا، خصوصا لو اتكلمنا على الديتيلز بتاعة الريسك فاكتور. يعني لو اتكلمنا عن الانفكشن، لو عن الفيلير اوف بروسيدور، لو على البليدنج، لو على البرفوريشن اوف فيسكس، ده كله كومبليكيشن كود بي هابند. واتكلمنا على الوي بتاع اللونج تيرم كير، وده الحاله دي اصلا لما جت في الامتحان كانت جايه على الكونسيرن بتاع البيشنت بتاع الفاميلي على اللونج تيرم كير، هو ازاي كان فيد هيم ان ذا هوم يعني. فكان السؤال اللونج تيرم كير هو مش هيقدر يعمل له اي هيلب في الهوم، فكان السؤال اللي احنا الرينج مع السوشيال وركر، مع الفيزيوثيرابي، مع السبيتش ثيرابي، مع النيورولوجيكال كونسلتنت النيورولوجيست، ونشوف له لونج تيرم كير ان اذر هوسبيتال بيكوز ذيس هوسبيتال اتس اونلي فور اكيوت هوسبيتال فور اكيوت كيسز.
دكتور احمد، so the son has the right to refuse the procedure?
No, he hasn't the right. If the son refuses the procedure in the exam, he will tell him you will try to convince him, but if he doesn't, he didn't respond, he didn't, you can't persuade him, let him to, you will arrange for a second meeting with the consultant. The examiner, I told this issue many times before, the examiner will ask you if he still refused, that you would inform the not NHS. And there is a physician is called the IMICA physician, اللي هو ال Independent Mental Capacity Advocate. This one will assigned by NHS, and he will examine the patient, and he will see if this procedure in the best interest of the patient or not. Any question on this issue?
عفوا، ال NHS دي اختصار ايه؟
National Health Service. وزارة الصحة بريطانيا. نعم.
الإيميكا.
Independent Mental Capacity Advocate. معلش يعني مش هنكمل الحلقة الرابعة، لأن يعني حاسس إن صوتي واقع. فإن شاء الله، إن شاء الله نعملها المرة الجاية يعني.
إن شاء الله بإذن الله.
إن شاء الله. أي سؤال أو
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله يخليك.
سلامتك أنت.
يخليك يا الله يخليك.
السلام على حضرتك، عندكم بتعملوا التيست بتاع الإنفلونزا؟
يا دكتور محمد خليها ماشية كده.
طب عليك باليانسون يا بيه، اليانسون كويس بيقولوا بيستخرج منه أقل كام كيلو.
انا برضو خايف ان اخد ينسون فانسى كتير، انا ما بحبش انسى.
لا ان شاء الله اختار شيء.
السلام عليكم.
الف سلام على حضرتك.
السلام عليكم.
نيجي للسيناريو الاخير بتاع النهارده اللي هو الدراج اوفر دوز. دكتور رشا، كل ما نيجي نعمل سيناريو عندها الشبكة تفصل مننا في النت، فإن شاء الله ده المرة دي تعملي خلاص. حاضر. دكتور رشا.
أيوة
تمام.
كيف تتصرف؟
الصوت واضح كده الحمد لله. مسز منى 23 years old. She was admitted yesterday because she was received paracetamol overdose. She has assisted by the physician and the blood level of the paracetamol was seen. Inositol was started for patient and liver functions and CBC and EBG was done for this patient. The result was released and there is high level of paracetamol. You are called by the staff nurse. This patient wants to discharge from the hospital. Your task to explain for this patient what is the importance of continue admission at the hospital and what is the next, what is the management plan. نعم.
Your task
is. السمعك يا فندم.
Your task is doctor.
Your task to explain to the patient the management plan and what is the important to continue admission at the hospital. بالمناسبة الدراج اوفر دوز الحالة يعني بتبقى أكتر منها history عن communication، يعني تقريبا نص الكلام هيبقى history.
Liver function doctor and CBC and EBG normal.
All investigation normal apart from increased level of blood cholesterol. Sorry, increased level of paracetamol. تفضلي.
Good morning. I'm Dr. Rasha. Is this Mrs. Mona?
Yes, Dr. Good morning.
How are you, Mrs. Mona?
I feel better.
How are you?
I feel better than yesterday, Dr.
Okay. Today, Mrs. Mona, I'm going to discuss with you the results of your blood test. Is that okay with you?
Yes, doctor.
How do you feel so far, Mrs. Mona?
I feel better than yesterday. There is no tummy pain and there is no feeling sick or cut sick. I wanted to discharge from hospital today because my condition is improving now.
Okay. So, Mrs. Mona, there is no more nausea, no more pain in your tummy. Do you feel any sick?
No.
Okay, that's good, Mrs. Mullah. I know it has been hard time that you have tried to take an overdose and hurt yourself, right?
Yes, doctor. I received about 20 tablets of paracetamol, and it was yesterday in the evening, now about 12 hours. I assessed by the physician in emergency room, and he told me about the admission because the condition could be serious. But I feel better today, so I want for discharge from the hospital.
Okay, Mrs. You've took 20 tablets.
Yes.
Okay, you home batch or one by one?
All at the same time.
You took another kind of tablet or only this tablet?
Only this tablet.
Have you took with this some alcohol, some vodka, something like this?
No.
Okay. Mrs. Munaz, can I'm here to help you as much as I can, but can you tell me before you start to take, you are going to take this drug, what was your plan?
I feel, doctor, the life is black, and I wanted to terminate my life. So I received this medication to terminate my life.
I'm really sorry for this, Mrs. Mona. But have you wrote any note? Have you planned any plans to do this? You secure to be alone in your home?
I want to be alone most of the time, but I didn't write any plan or any notes.
Okay. When you took this this pill, after that have you told anybody that you have access? Hello.
No, doctor. I don't know anyone.
Okay. Mrs. Muna, do you have any past history of any psychiatric before?
No.
Have you ever tried to end your life?
This time, doctor, yes, I want to terminate my life.
Before, have you ever tried to do this?
No.
Do you take any, are you addicted on any drugs? Taking drugs?
No.
Okay. Now, how do you feel about yourself, Mrs. Mora?
I feel guilty about that, and I want to discharge from the hospital.
So you feel guilty about this?
Yes.
Okay. Do you think, Mrs. Muna, that you are in need of help?
No, doctor.
Okay. Do you sleep well, Mrs. Muna?
Yes.
You sleep well?
I sleep well, yes, doctor.
Okay. How have you been feeling within yourself?
Could you repeat that, please?
How have you been feeling within yourself?
Yes, doctor. As I told you, I feel the life was black, but I feel guilty after I received this medication, and I want to start from the hospital to continue my life and to improve my income.
Okay. Can I know what makes you feel this way?
Yes, doctor. I fired from my job, and at the same time, I divorced.
Oh, I'm so sorry for this. What do you do for life, Mrs. Mona?
I was working as a teacher.
And there's any reasons behind that you have been fired?
No.
Okay, and you've been married and you have been separated from your husband, right?
Yes, doctor.
Do you have any children?
No.
Okay, how do you support yourself financially?
Now there's no in support because I was dependent on the income from my work. Now I get fired from my work, and I will try to apply for another job.
For another, it must be very bad experience for you, Mrs. Mola, I know.
Yes, Dr. Thanks.
Okay. Is there any past history of family history of any mental problems?
No.
Okay. What can I know? What is the reason behind that you don't want to stay any longer in the hospital?
No, doctor. Just I feel better, and I feel now no tummy pain, and there is no nausea or no becoming sick or feeling sick. So that I feel better to complete my medication at home, and you can prescribe for me this medication.
Well, Mrs. Mona, I want to tell you that the result of your blood that has measured that to measure the percentage of the drug you have took is very high. And it might be, and at that time, it might be there's a serious problem going on with your liver at any time. So you must be under observation so as that any deterioration in your condition would be seen as soon as possible by the doctor, and we try to help you as much as we can. If you get home, you might be unable to call for help.
You repeat that last.
How do you feel? Mrs. Mona, I want to tell you that the level of paracetamol you took is very high, and this means that your liver might be affected, and also this can make your liver be damaged.
Yes, doctor, but I was informed by the nurse. All that investigation related to the liver and kidney problem are normal.
Yes, Mrs. Mona, but might be there is, at any time there must be any deterioration, so we try to admit you to stay in the hospital to keep care on you. If anything wrong happens, we then run to avoid its progress. Because might be your liver get damaged from the high paracetamol.
Yes, doctor, you can prescribe for me this medication, and I'll come back tomorrow to repeat some investigation as you required.
Well, Mrs. Mona, you cannot. You have to be on the hospital to be. Called up by the doctors, and there is no medications you can take at home.
But I feel better, doctor.
Can you tell me, yes, Mrs. Mona, I appreciate that you want to redischarge, but can you tell me the reason behind that you don't want to stay in the hospital?
There's
is there
no
anything
reason.
Urgent you want to do it?
No, doctor, there's no reason for that. Just I feel better, so that I want to go home.
So that they want
to go home.
If you okay, Mrs. Vilma, if you insist to go home, you should write a forum that you have. Although that it was recommended for you to stay in the hospital according to the recommendation of the doctor, and you want to be discharged, you should write a self-discharge consent.
No problem.
Okay?
No problem for that, doctor. I can write that, and no problem to write and sign on this form.
Okay, but I assure you, Mrs. Mona, if you feel any deterioration in your condition, you can call at any time. I can give you the number of the ambulance to call if there is any problem has been happened to you. Okay?
Okay, doctor, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mrs. Mona.
End of discussion. Dr. Asha.
Yes, okay.
You can make end of discussion, just to make summary and
okay, doctor. So, Mrs. Muna, do you have any other things that you'd like to tell me?
No, not just to prepare the medication that I can take it at home, and I will sign this consent for the discharge from the hospital.
Okay, Mrs. Muna, to summarize for you, you have been admitted to the hospital because you've got a very a large dose of paracetamol, and we did a liver function and some blood tests. Among them, the level of paracetamol, and it's proved to be high. And you've been recommended to stay in the hospital so as to be monitored closely. If there any deterioration in your breathing or in your liver function, and for some reason you don't want to stay in the hospital, and you have to write a form of self-discharge that you want to be discharged despite the medical recommendation to stay, and you should feel free to come back again and seek help if your condition has been deteriorated.
Okay.
Is that okay with you, Mr. Horton?
No problem for that. Thank you. You did well, but last question you didn't answer it. When the patient insists for discharge from the hospital, I want to ask you, is this patient high risk for recurrent attack of the sudden attempt or no?
I was again, doctor?
This patient has high risk of recurrent suicidal attempts or no?
I asked her about if she has any previous psychological problems, if any symptoms of depression, and she feels okay all the way.
Yes, she feels okay. She told you that she wants to terminate her her life too, and she wants to end her life. Is this one of the risk factor or high risk factor of suicidal attempts?
Yes, doctor. I think if she, if I was approaching very well to her, I should admit, let the psychiatric doctor to have an appointment with her, and might he admit her in the psychiatric ward to give her antidepressant, and hear from another self harm to herself.
Yes, that's good. Now, the patient wants to discharge from the hospital. You told her that she has to sign the discharge against the medical advice paper. And what do you think is this patient with high risk of suicidal attempt? You can allow her for discharge from the hospital, or you have to admission for this patient again in the term of common law?
I think if she is
a patient
and has his own autonomy.
Yes, I know that we can respect the patient autonomy and the patient request, but there is some condition we can't follow up the patient request, like the patient with high risk or another suicidal attempts, or patient with has infectious disease.
Oh.
And if you have patient with tuberculosis and the patient wants to discharge against medical advice, you will not allow him to discharge against medical advice because this condition serious for public. But this patient with high risk for suicidal attempt, we have to try to persuade her or convince her to stay in the hospital at least to complete the medication. And after that, try to get approach for her. Many people comes in the same attacks. Some people need more help with another expertise physicians. It is a psychiatric physician. Psychiatric physician, that is, doesn't mean you have a problem in your brain. He will help you to assess your condition. Maybe you have some sort called depression. It could be minor and they need only medical treatment and your condition will improve. So it is wise for us to refer you for more assessment by psychiatrist. We have to mention for that when this patient has high risk. If the patient has low risk or medium risk, yes, you can discharge here and give her appointment with psychiatrist. But if this patient with high risk, you have to keep her in the hospital for assessment by psychiatrist. But what is
high
the
risk, sorry doctor for interruption, but okay. High risk means that she has psychiatric problems of previous suicidal attack or drug addict.
Yes, high risk means what it means by high risk, I will tell you. High risk, as you told, to assist the patient with psychiatric with drug overdose, we can assess what is the pre-event and during an event and after event. Pre-event, we ask about another previous history of the same attack. She has any depression or psychic problem. She has she writes note or writes a plan. She wants to terminate her life or end her life. All these are high risk. During the attack, this patient taking medication without inform other friends. She keep she locked the door. Okay. After attack, she got symptoms like this patient has pain and vomiting, and also there's elevation of the inositol cysteine. This patient has a risk. If this all symptoms are negative, that is mean the patient doesn't have any risk of recurrent suicidal attempts.
But before I already asked her about this, but she said no.
No, but she told you that she doesn't mention for any of friends she will about the drug overdose. She has she want to terminate her life. This is both risk and both are high risk. For suicide, for the recurrent suicidal attempts. It's very, very important to know if the patient insists for the charge and the patient asks you to discharge her, tell her that you will call for her now psychiatric physician. He will stay with her and he will decide if you want to discharge, if you can discharge from the hospital or not. Other very important thing about the medical condition observation, liver enzymes are normal and the renal functions are normal. That doesn't guarantee for the patient next investigation will be normal because paracetamol could be affect the renal and the liver functions even after 12 to 24 hours. It's another important note we have to mention for the patient to try to convince her for the hospital, to convince her to stay in the hospital. As lab tests now are normal, but could be raised after 12 hours to 24 hours. Any comment?
دكتور احمد, هي ممكن ترد عليا تقول لي لو السايكاتري will not have the role to assess me if I have to stay in the hospital or not, ساعتها اقول لها ايه او حاجه زي كده.
انت حضرتك تقول ان السايكاتريست ماليش رول يعني؟
ان هي ممكن تقول.
رديت على السؤال ده وانت حضرتك كنت اوف لاين.
معلش, ما انا هفكر, سوري.
مفيش مشكله. I will tell her that I am here to help you. I am internist, so that I am concerned about the medical problem, but could be the cause of your condition. Something minor condition, it's called depression, and it, the psychiatrist will assess your condition. It could be your condition need only treatment or to stay with the psychiatrist for sessions. You can he expertise in this issue and he can help you about your if he finds that you have any problem related to depression.
Okay.
I ممكن تقول لك انا مش مجنونة. عشان توديني للسايكاتري تقول لك I am not mad مثلا, تقول لها سايكاتريست many people that comes by the same condition, that is doesn't mean you have any brain insult, just a minor depression, most of people visit psychiatrist just for helping. Any other question? انا حاسس الناس الحمد لله بتتكلم confidence اكتر من اول بكتير يعني. Any other question?